Hi, everyone. We're coming to you live from the Cushman & Wakefield booth at ICSC Recon 2019 to bring you what's next in retail. I'm Alana Leffler, head of marketing for America's Retail Services at Cushman & Wakefield. And with us this afternoon is James Shaniga, Senior Director of Technology Strategy and Sponsors. How are you?
Great. Technology Strategy and Partnerships.
Yep,
it's all right. It's a new title, too. So, yeah, great. Doing well. We're excited. We've formalized a partnership with OuterNets, who's helping some of our retail landlords to shorten the amount of time that there's spaces on the market, we hope, while providing also some incredible analytics on engagement and passersby.
Yeah, and we've got them here at the booth. We've got a few different locations. They're there giving promos, showing everybody how they're taking their technology, putting it in storefront windows. I understand it pulls back-end data on whoever's interacting with that technology.
Yeah, it does. It's really interesting. I think for Cushman & Wakefield's standpoint, understanding what the data is of who's looking at it, who's passing by, who's engaging with it, what they're engaging is the thing that's most exciting to us. When I looked about an hour ago, something like 13,000 people had passed by the unit just to your right.
Wow.
And 183 women had looked at it, and 255 men had looked at it, and the average amount of engagement time was 5 seconds. And you begin to put together a very rich picture of who your audience is and what matters to them when you have data like that. We're very excited to bring that to our retail partners.
Yeah, that's great. I mean, I think for our clients on the investor side, on the occupier side, they can then take that data and understand who their audience is in that space. So on the investor side or landlord, they can take that data and understand who's passing by. They can start to interact and ask questions of who do you want to see in the space, what retail category, and understand who that audience is. And on the occupier side, then they can try to understand who the audience is so they know who to sell to or what products might sell. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's correct. In fact, at one of the pilot sites that we did on 3rd Avenue in Manhattan, there was a space that was vacant for a year, and they worked with OuterNets to put up a sign that engaged people, that got their attention, said, hey, you, and got them to come over to the sign and then asked them a simple like pop quiz, what kind of store would you like to see here? 37% of the respondents responded with a certain answer, and a month later that place was rented out. So we're really eager to see if that kind of traction repeats itself the more of these storefronts that we activate. Meanwhile, we're getting this very robust street level view of who is where and what interests them in a way that none of our competitors will have. So that's very exciting for us.
Absolutely, and of course they want to see their retailers be successful, and I guess understanding that that's what everybody's looking for in that area, it basically ensures that.
Yeah, it does. For the tenants themselves, for the brands that already work with OuterNets, there's another engagement opportunity for them as well, because it allows them to put on targeted advertising and targeted promotions to demographics that they want to select and target those promotions with to, and then engage those people on the street, try to attract them from passersby to walkers in with enticements to come and shop inside the store. And so it's been very successful for a lot of brands. There's a lot of interest in it. We're just very excited that we're adding this to the quiver of arrows of partner technologies at Cushman & Wakefield.
That's great. I mean, I'm sure our brokers are really going to find this valuable to bring to their clients, and I know we're really excited to have them. So what other partnerships are you looking at, or have you began to develop at Cushman & Wakefield with Outside?
Yeah, well, it's a very exciting time. We've got a couple of them. Some of them are I saw here in the building today in Las Vegas. One that we're very proud of that is helping, particularly our office brokers, is Saltmine, which provides us with a space planning platform where you can build test fits in a matter of weeks and mock out a bunch of different ways that an office floor plan could look, begin to get a rough estimate of what those costs will look like, and then as you center in on what the client wants as the final design, begin working with our PDS group and our architects in St. Louis to really build that out and make sure that we have the level of quality and service that, of course, our customers come to expect. And that's
right.
Where that blend of partner technology and Cushman & Wakefield know-how, really marries together really well. So that's a very exciting product. That's one example. In retail as well, I saw Virtual APT out in the convention center.
They're the ones with there's like a robot going around outside.
Right, exactly. It looks like a miniature indoor version of the Google Street View car,
yeah,
right? So you can imagine
exactly
driving
it.
Around. It's
right.
got this 3D camera on the top of
right.
it. And it very quickly gets either street level or inside the building 3D panoramic walkthroughs of space.
Oh.
And so so we're using that, you know, both on the outside of buildings by displaying that on outer nets units, say, or inside of our Prism GIS mapping device,
okay.
where what you're doing is you're looking for floor plans inside of a building that are available for lease and want to see what that looks like. So you can click on the floor in the stacking plan and then tour the floor with virtual APT. So they're another really good partner.
That's amazing. So basically the user on the other side going through and controlling where this robot kind of goes around the space to view?
The robot will go through the space,
okay.
But what you can do when you're looking at it is use your mouse or use your finger to look in three directions. The robot's going to go in a path, but you can use either a mouse or your finger on a touchscreen
yeah.
to look around, or if you've got an augmented reality device like a phone,
right?
You can look and see what's behind you.
Oh, so that sounds incredible!
It's pretty cool, right? The ability to go from, you know, zooming into the city, flying into a skyline, clicking on a building to be able to see the stacking plan of available floor plates, to click on that stacking plan and then either, you know, look at what a test fit could look like in that floor plan, or actually physically what it looks like with a 3D walkthrough.
Right.
Both of which are because of some of our technology partnerships. That's an incredibly compelling visual story. And it makes us very proud at Cushman & Wakefield to talk about our technology that way.
Absolutely, and it looks like it's something that will work well for office and for retail, so this way it's something that we can all take advantage of.
It is, yeah. Bringing it back to retail, there are a lot of things that we're seeing in the space with technology that have us very excited. We're excited about outer nets, of course. We're also looking at two or three more companies that we're doing pilots in. Select cities to be able to see whether the technology works, whether the technology scales, whether it's easy to use, and whether it's an easy partner to work with. But it's exciting times. You know, I think the next thing that we're going to see has to do with understanding better than ever before what is available on a retail strip, mm-hmm. on a high street, better than ever before being able to do predictive site selection. Right. These are capabilities that our brokers have asked us for. There are a number of companies that are in this space that are doing those things that are interesting to look at. And it's fun. And, you know, just being here at the Convention Center for ICSC at Recon, they've got an entire, you know, emerging technology row out there.
Yes.
That you can walk through and you can begin looking at, you know, what seems to be coming down the pipe. So that's
yeah.
exciting.
This is the second year I think they're doing the Innovation Exchange. There's lots of emerging brands and technology and how it's being incorporated in retail. It's pretty neat.
Yeah, absolutely. It's fun.
That must be your home base here today. It must be immersed.
I definitely go and I pay attention to that. Yeah,
yeah,
we're looking at that. There are some companies that I was speaking to just before this that, you know, that various technology applications that are tools in our toolbox are looking to expand. So that you know, we can add features and functionality to that, so that by partnering, we get these capabilities that would take too long to build in-house. It's
right.
generally a better quality than you would make if you were trying to build it from scratch. We don't need to reinvent that wheel. And as the technology improves, we're not stuck with this old technology.
Mm-hmm.
Either our partners improve or we add to them.
Right.
Right? And that's, you know, we think that that's going to put the best possible technology in the hands of our brokers, in the hands of our client-facing professionals, in the hands of our clients, and be very distinguishing for Cushman.
Well, I mean, I love that we're doing all these things to stay current, stay with the trends, and look to the future. So thank you for joining us, James.
Thanks very much, Alana. It's a pleasure. Thank you.
I hope you enjoy the rest of your conference. Thank you all for tuning in, and check back throughout the day as we come to you live from the Cushman & Wakefield booth at Recon 2019.